Hello and welcome to Aftershoot, a revolutionary system to speed up your workflow. In today's video, we're going over how to cull and edit using Aftershoot. So to get started, you're gonna open up your Aftershoot and run a cull. I've taken the liberty already to have something run pre-culled, so I'm gonna double click on the view button next to culling. And as you're going to see, it's going to load our images. We had 4,683 images reduced to 1,559 images. We have 149 highlights, totaling 1,708 images. First things first, we want to make sure we're reviewing our images in Aftershoot. There's a lot of different things and different workflows that you can take to review these images. You can do anything from culling in and using the My Selections tool. You can spray can, you can add, swap, you can check out your closed eyes, your blurred, or you can just look at your warnings and see what you need to get rid of. So there's a lot of different ways to go through and finalize this information. What I'm gonna say first and foremost is that Aftershoot rocks. If you'd like to learn more about how to work within Aftershoot for culling, be sure to check out some of our workflow videos. In this video, we're just going over the process of going from Aftershoot and getting these images edited and culled within the Aftershoot platform. So when you've gone through and revised and tweaked and adjusted all of your culling results, the first thing you want to do is decide whether or not you're going to edit all of your images or just a portion of the images. For my personal workflow, my favorite thing is to actually bring all of my images into Lightroom for editing. So what I'm gonna do is actually just head on over to Lightroom, open up my Lightroom catalog, and I'm gonna just import all of the images. So they've already culled, they have their star ratings and their star filters. I personally just like to have all of my images within Lightroom. You know, sometimes I wanna just like do some Photoshop things or try something creative on some extra images or just have a black and white version of something. So I love to have everything in there. I make smaller catalogs as it is. So, you know, 5 weddings per catalog. So having 5,000 images in each one is totally fine. And I just use the filter system. So it's something that you're gonna kind of learn a little bit through this workflow. But again, if you're looking for workflow specific videos, be sure to check out some of those videos for us. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm actually going to go down and find this folder. This is Nathan and Kim. I'm going to make sure that the checkbox for build smart previews is checked. So I wanna make sure that I'm building smart previews for my images when I import them. So it's two birds with one stone, because what that means is that Aftershoot edits itself will perform a lot faster because it won't have to make its own previews. It'll be able to just access the Lightroom ones. So the editing process for this should be very, very fast once I get that step taken care of. So again, make sure you build the smart previews here. I do apply a preset on import. You don't necessarily have to, but again, it's a great step. Aftershoot won't overwrite anything that it doesn't touch. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on import. And what's gonna happen now is it's going to go in, import all of these images, right? So it's gonna drag everything in. So we're gonna head back into Aftershoot while that's going on. And we're gonna just take a step back and I'm gonna show you what it looks like to actually connect these images. Now, we won't be able to proceed with editing because our Lightroom catalog is already open. But as soon as we close that catalog, so once the import is complete and the smart previews are built, we'll be able to actually launch right into editing, let it run, and then open up and review those edits in Lightroom. So now I'm actually able to click on resume or start if you hadn't opened it already. Now I'm presented with a screen in which I'm going to connect my Lightroom catalog to begin editing. First things first, you're gonna see the toggle for apply my Lightroom preset. Again, as mentioned before, if you applied a preset on import, you don't necessarily need to swipe this on. But if you did not apply a preset on import, we do recommend this because, as mentioned, if you have a tone curve adjustment, if you have camera calibration, if you're using split toning or color grading at all, those sort of things won't be applied by Aftershoot. Those are preset quantities. So if you say apply my Lightroom preset, it'll start applying those the most used tone curve, the most used split toning. It'll go through the process and find that preset that you use the most and apply those values that Aftershoot doesn't auto-correct itself. So again, it's highly recommended that you put this on. In our troubleshooting video, you'll see the first thing you're gonna end up going to if you don't have good edits is to make sure that your tone curve, your split toning, and your camera calibration are as expected. Next, I'm gonna go ahead and choose my AI profile. These are gonna show all of my profiles that I've created. So we're gonna use a Thanksgiving profile, one that I created on Thanksgiving. I'm also gonna make sure that I'm clicking on the right profile. So again, I use Adobe Standard. If you are uncertain of what you would normally use, I'm also gonna decide to crop and straighten this here. And then next thing I would do is connect my Lightroom catalog. So we're gonna go ahead and find the Lightroom catalog that we're importing to. Now we will get an error message. We're not gonna be able to actually do this because that catalog is open, but I can queue it up. So we're gonna go ahead and select that file. Select the file. And now you can see it says close the catalog in Lightroom and retry. And you'll also see that there's a little note that says using raw files for editing. Now we're building the smart previews and they're not quite built yet. But I also have another problem that I just want to point out in this video in case you're watching. I have the duplicate catalog. So this catalog is called Weddings Part 6 Copy.lrcap. Now, if I were to actually go to the source file here, you're gonna notice that I have smart previews that are actually called Weddings Part 6 Smart Previews. That's where the smart previews are. They're not actually built next to my Part 6 copy. So if you've renamed your catalog recently and rebuilt smart previews or done anything like that, this is actually an issue that could arise if you have a copy of a catalog or the catalog's changed names, right? So if you've upgraded from Lightroom V11 to V12, now your catalog's gonna say Lightroom V11-V12. So if you're having issues connecting those smart previews, you just wanna go to the place where the catalog is actually located and make sure that the smart previews are named accordingly. So we're gonna let that finish importing. And then I'm actually gonna go ahead and rename those smart previews so that they actually line up with what we need it to say. So we're gonna just add copy in here, and now it's going to appear with that catalog. So we'll head back to this catalog and see, and we'll make sure that the smart previews actually are going to be created in that section. Now Lightroom has completed building its smart previews. We're gonna click on OK. So our smart previews have been built. If you've already imported and you don't have smart previews available in library mode, you can simply click on library, previews, and build smart previews. And again, just select all the images you wanna build smart previews for, and library, previews, and build smart previews, and those will build. So now what we're going to do is actually quit out of Lightroom because Lightroom needs to be closed for this to work. So Aftershoot edits cannot edit an open Lightroom catalog. It risks corruption if we edit that open catalog. So we wanna make sure that it's closed. What I'm gonna do is actually go ahead and click, I'm gonna just close out of that. We're gonna go ahead and choose that catalog that has the smart previews built. We're gonna click on select files. So now it's gonna again warn me that I have a large Lightroom catalog because this one has quite a few weddings in it. You can see the smart previews are automatically attached. I'm not gonna crop and straighten for this version. I wanna just run it through. And this is a little bit more of a composed wedding. Everything was with flash, so there's a lot less of just kind of shutter shooting images and a lot more like dialing in and focusing on it. So the framing should be all good for this. So what I'm gonna do, I have all of my 5-star images, as you can see from that Lightroom. It's just my 5-star images. I actually built a collection of those, so it's Nathan and Kim selected. So I have 1,708 photos to edit in that collection. These are all my 5-star images. So I'm just gonna click on edit photos, and we're gonna let Aftershoot go ahead and run through its things. So first step again is just making sure that all the smart previews exist. Everything within the smart previews needs to be available to us. Next thing that's gonna happen is it's actually gonna go through and run the editing program. So it's gonna use the models that have downloaded to your computer and run them. Again, no internet connection required. You can actually just have this run on the fly. And I'm just gonna talk a little bit here because this should be a relatively quick process. 1,708 photos. We're about 51 seconds away on step one. So we'll just run through a couple different processes here, but it shouldn't take more than a few minutes. It's really important to make sure that when you're creating your profile, that you're using the right data to create it. What you give Aftershoot to learn from will directly impact what comes out of it when it comes to edits. So what that means is that if you're giving it a very biased data set, so you're only giving it the best situations and a lot of the same situations, when you come to a different situation, it's not really gonna know how to operate and how to edit in your style because you've created a bias within your data. Now this workflow is one of many workflows available to you. Some people prefer to cull their images, import just the selected images into Lightroom. But again, you always will have to take your images from Aftershoot's culling software and bring it into Lightroom before you're able to actually edit it. We need to be able to access the Lightroom catalog so that we can tell Lightroom what edits to apply to what images. So they all do need to be in Lightroom before you get started. In just a short few minutes, there you have it. We were able to actually edit everything within that Lightroom catalog, within that collection that was 5 stars. So 1,700 photos, all of about 2 minutes to get that done. And then again, we're on our final screen. So this is where you can actually decide to edit again. So you can click on edit again and apply a different preset if you'd like, or change the photos that you want to edit. So it does give you the ability to go in and do those sort of things. And you also have your improve AI buttons here, so you're able to actually re-upload the catalog after you've made your tweaks so that you're able to make the AI become more intelligent over time. But my favorite button is this one. Review in Lightroom, because we're gonna get going and open this up and start the editing process. So what's gonna happen is it's going to prompt us to open Lightroom. I do have some plugins here, so it's gonna tell me that I have permission errors. So now I'm gonna land on my library screen. Now it's super important to note that the library screen doesn't instantly update because Lightroom hasn't totally acknowledged that we've edited all of these images so quickly. So there are a couple of hacks to kind of get around this. One would be potentially just changing something across all of the images, right? So you could maybe turn the vibrance down a little bit and turn it back up. And what it would do is force Lightroom to understand that it needs to update these previews. But again, this process is solely dependent on the speed of Lightroom. So it's looking at Lightroom to say, hey, all these previews need to update because they've changed. So again, don't base your first results just by scrolling through library mode because the edits may not have loaded. So what I'm gonna do is actually enter develop screen. And now what we're gonna see is a much different looking image than we saw in that preview. So we have our final edited version. And again, this is where you go through and you tweak and you adjust to help make the AI smarter over time. The more information you're giving it and the more understanding it has, the better it becomes over time. But again, consistency is an extremely important factor to all of this. So now that we've entered that screen, we're gonna actually scroll down and find some more examples of maybe some stuff where it didn't quite show up yet. So we have an image like this. When I enter develop mode, you're gonna see it's going to look a lot different than that preview did. But again, I may wanna tweak this a little bit. You know, it's not a condition that I've ever trained it on. So this is actually a tinted window. So I didn't have any examples to give the AI for this. So the white balance is a little bit confused because the tint is really just, it's daylight, but it's not daylight. So it's making it a little bit too cool. So I can make those fine-tune adjustments and again, re-upload it and retrain it for it to hopefully get better in the future at situations like that. If you have any issues or you run into any snags, please do reach out to us. We have 24-hour in-app support, so you're able to reach out, let us know what's going on, and we can try and help troubleshoot you and figure out exactly what it is, whether it's issues with bugs within the software, or if you're facing any specific issues with your edits not turning out the way you expect, we can help you kind of figure out whether it's a tone curve or a mid-tone or something that's just kind of causing it to be off. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to tune into some of our other videos to learn more about what Aftershoot can do for you.